Amina Khan is here in PK Maths is Fun. This is video number 3 on kinematic. In the previous two videos, we have seen the application of differentiation in kinematic, and we have seen the sketches of displacement time graph and velocity time graph, and seen the question with respect to those two sketches. In this video, we will see application of integration in kinematic. Those two videos link I will attach in the description below. So if you want to see, you can refer it. We know when we integrate acceleration equation, we get a velocity equation. When we integrate a velocity equation, we get a displacement equation. So let's just start with the question straight away. We have already done things in detail, the whole thing. So here we will start with the question straight away. An object P moves in a straight line so that its velocity is given by this, where T is the time in second after leaving a point A, which is 5 meters away from O. So this line means when t is equals to 0, your s is equals to 5. And when t is equals to 0, your v is equals to, you don't know that right now, right? No, it is given. When t is equals to 0, v is equals to 3, right? It is given in the equation, so you can figure it out. Now, why these type of hint, like for example, this one is given to you? Because when you integrate, you get an arbitrary constant. And to find out the value of arbitrary constant, you have to substitute values. So those conditions, those values are given to you in the question, which you have to figure out. So first, we have to find the expression for displacement in terms of t. It means I need to integrate this velocity equation straight away. So when I integrate it, it is 2t cube over 3. I'm sure you know how to integrate polynomial equation. And here I will substitute the value t0, s5. And I'll get my value of c. This will help me to know my displacement equation. Now next part of the question is saying, find the values of t when p is instantaneously at rest. Now instantaneously at rest means when v is 0. So I will find out my velocity equation, and no need to find it, is already given here. So I will put it equals to 0 and I will solve it. So I put v is equals to 0 and I got value of t 1/2 and 3. Now what does it explain to you? It explains to you that when you start your journey at t equals to 0, after 1/2 second the object took a turn, right? It means about turn in the reverse direction. Then after 3 seconds from the beginning, it took a turn again and moved in this direction. So this is the way particle is moving. It will not take another turn because there is no other value of t. Two values of t mean only at those two instant the particle took about turn, right? Now next part of the question is saying, find the distance of P from O at t equals to 2 seconds. So I will find out my displacement equation and I will put t is equals to 2 in that equation. So to find out the displacement equation, I need to integrate velocity equation again. So here is the, sorry, I think I missed one page. Okay, displacement equation we already have here. We have found in part one. So we will just put t is equals to 2 in this equation and we will get the displacement, which means distance of P from O, right? So because we have already found displacement equation in part one, we just need to put t equals to 2 in it. And this is what we have done here. So when t is equals to 2, displacement is 2/1/3 meters. Okay. Now, the last part of the question, you have to find the total distance traveled in 5 seconds. Now, interesting is that we already know that object took turn at 1/2 second at 3 seconds. So I cannot straight away just put 5 in displacement equation, which I have found here. If I will put 5, which is a common mistake students make at times, when t is equals to 5, we substitute in the displacement equation. It simply gives us distance from t equals to 0 second to 5 second straight away. I mean, it gives you the displacement. It doesn't give you the total distance it has taken a turns in between, right? So that's why we have to do it in steps, in 3 steps. So you need to find out, first of all, how much particle was away from fixed point O at these timings, 0 second, half second, 3 second, and 5 second. So you are substituting these values of time in displacement equation, right? Which is given here. So when t0, s is 5, when t is half, displacement is 5 whole 17 upon 24. It means t is equals to 3, it is half meter. At 5, it is 15 whole 5 upon 6 meter. So I will show you with the help of graph also. Rather, let me explain it to you first of all here. Now look at this graph. Rough sketch, basically, not graph, rough sketch. When I put t is equals to 0, answer was 5. It means object was 5 meter away on the right hand side from O. When we put t equals to half, the answer was 5 whole 17 upon 24. Now this answer is again from O. Remember it, please. Right? That's why we have written this. So if you have to find out how much distance covered in half second, you need to minus this from this. Sorry. This from this, because this distance minus this distance, it will give you how much it is covered, right? Now, after that, when you put t equals to 3, the distance is half. Again, it is from origin. It means in 3 seconds, object has gone all the way from here till here. And then in 5 seconds, when you substitute it in the displacement equation, you got 15 whole 5 upon 6. It means again from origin, 15 whole 5 upon 6 is here. So this blue line is telling you the total distance covered. So the easy way to handle this is, just let me write here, I think I wrote here. Here, yes. You find out the distance covered from 0 second to half second, because starting from here, first time turn, then from first time turn to second time turn, you see? 3 seconds, half second, and from 3 seconds till wherever you have to find the distance, that time. So all these values which are given here, 5 here, s half is 5 whole 17 upon 24 here, modulus, because if answer comes negative, you ignore negative sign. Then the same value of half will come here, 5 whole 17 upon 24. Then s3 is half, s3 means 3 seconds, how much displacement. What is the displacement from origin? So I'm simply substituting the value, then half minus 15 whole 5 upon 6. Sorry, it is not very clear. It is written here, but I'm just writing it. So now you can subtract and add the values. So this is your total distance. So you don't need to sketch this, as long as you know that you have to subtract two distances at what time. I hope it is clear to you. So let's see the next question. In this question, it is acceleration equation is given to you and particle is moving in a straight line passing a fixed point O. Now, this is a fixed point O. When particle passes through here, the velocity was 16. And it is saying t is the time after passing O. It means t is 0 here. So what information we have? When t is 0, v is 16. And we will need this information when we will integrate acceleration equation, because we will get arbitrary constant. So find the value of t when the particle is instantaneously at rest. Instantaneously at rest means when v is 0. So we need to find the velocity equation first, and we need to put v 0 to get time. So first of all, when we integrate acceleration equation, we get velocity equation with respect to arbitrary constant. So we plug in these values, we got C16. So here is the velocity equation. Because it is saying instantaneously at rest, I have to find the value of t. So I will put V0 and I will solve quadratic equation to get the values of t. So here it is, and I got the value of t, 2 and 8. Again, it means a particle is taking turn at 2 points, from 0 to 2 second, then 2 to 8 second, then 8 to, like this, right? What is the direction? I'm not talking about it, but I'm just roughly telling you what it is. What does it mean? Okay. Now, next part of the question is saying, find the displacement of the particle when t is 5. It means I need to know the displacement equation, and in that equation, I will put t5. So how you will do it? You will integrate velocity equation again. Now, again, you get arbitrary constant. You can use any letter. So what values you will plug in here? When t is 0, s is 0, right? So you put t 0, s 0, and you got your arbitrary constant c1, which is 0. So this is your displacement equation. And how do we get this information? We get all this information from here. When t is the time after passing over. So it means when t is 0, s is 0, because displacement equation gives distance from origin every time. Now, the total distance traveled by the particle in the first 5 seconds. So we have a displacement equation now. First 5 seconds, I cannot straight away put 5 in it, because object is not just moving on a straight line. It is going back and forth. So the timings were 2 and 8 seconds where it was taking turn. So I will find out distance covered from 0 second to 2 seconds. Then I will find out the distance covered from 2 seconds to 8. Oh, I don't need to go 8. I have to go till 5. So only till 5 here. That's all. Right? If I have to find distance in 10 seconds, then I will go from 2 second to 8 second, and then 8 second to whatever the time is. But right now it is 5. And 5 comes before 8. So this is I have to find out. So in the displacement equation, I will put t0, t2, and t5 to find out the distances, which I will plug in here. So here is the distance, 14.2 upon 3, and this. So these are the three distances I'm getting. So I can straight away substitute these values here, subtract them, and take the modulus values. This is the sketch just to explain it to you. And your total distance will come 32 whole number 2 upon 3. And the last part of the question is, what was it? The distance traveled by the particle in the fifth second. Now, this language is very important to understand. Fifth second means from fourth second till fifth second. It doesn't mean from the beginning till 5 seconds. So this is the difference between two. So you will find out the distance displacement in 5 seconds and the displacement in 4 seconds, and minus it straight away, right? Because this is origin, for example. In 4 seconds, this is the distance from origin. In 5 seconds, this is the displacement, for example, just assuming. Then if you minus the two, you will know how much distance was covered in 5 seconds, right? So we will do exactly the same thing. T equals to 5 distance, 4, T equals to 5, giving you this displacement. You will subtract the two things, which will add this up, and then you will get the total time, right? If I want to do it in the modulus, I will do it like this, s of 4 minus s of 5, and s of 4 is suppose 5 whole 1 upon 3 minus 3 whole 1 upon 3, and I will calculate it, right? Minus displacement always mean on the left-hand side of O. So with this, the examples are finished, and I have just put this chart here for your quick review if you want to have a look at it. We have already explained all this in the first video. So thank you very much for watching this video. And if you like it, please share and subscribe it with your friends. Thank you. Take care. Allah Hafiz.